I'm Dr. Leslie Citrome, Clinical Professor of Psychiatry and Behavioral Sciences at New York Medical College in Valhalla, New York. And with me is
Dr. Jonathan Meyer, Voluntary Clinical Professor of Psychiatry at the University of California in beautiful San Diego.
Let's go for this first one here.
Do LAIs prevent or delay hospital readmission? Well, one thing we understand is that most people with chronic illnesses, not just schizophrenia or non-adherent with oral medications, not me though, other people, right? That being said, many studies have shown, and there's different types of methodologies. There are randomized studies. There are what are called mirror image, where everyone's their own control. But the bulk of the literature shows that the use of LAIs, particularly in patients with schizophrenia, reduces the risk of relapse substantially. Does it reduce it to zero? It does not, because there's many reasons people may relapse, even when they're adherent with medication. But it's one of the best tools for reducing the risk of relapse.
Absolutely. You decrease the risk of relapse, you decrease the risk of rehospitalization. This has been seen in patients who've been hospitalized repeatedly, as well as first episode patients.
And I really want to add to the fact that we now recognize that because non-adherence is such a prevalent problem, and the consequences of non-adherence really may be irreversible, meaning effects on their brain, which may make it difficult to respond to antipsychotics. We think the state of the art these days is when people have their first diagnosis of schizophrenia to preferentially try and get them to respond to agents which have LAI options.
Absolutely. We need to offer long-acting injectables to more people and earlier on in the disease course. People who are at the early stage of their illness have the most to gain and the most to lose.
Next question. Do LAIs work better than oral antipsychotics? So it depends what you mean by better. If you had somebody who was 100% adherent with an oral medication, I would say the answer is no. We are only providing a mechanism of delivery which assures adherence. It does not necessarily make the medication more effective. So overall, we would say LAIs are not more effective, meaning if I have a certain reduction in symptoms on drug X, and I take that religiously, will I do better on the same LAI version? No. But from what I understand, most people are not 100% adherent.
No, the rate of partial or non-adherence in people with schizophrenia is about 50%. Now, before you start blaming people with schizophrenia as being, you know, the trouble here, it's actually the same percentage for those with bipolar disorder, major depressive disorder, anxiety disorder, diabetes, hypertension, and asthma.
And last but not least, do LAIs require a monthly injection? Well, we have a range now for LAIs, which go from as short of every 2 weeks up to every 6 months. And so you have a lot of options in a way we never had in years past, each of which should be tailored to the particular clinical situation for that patient. So for example, there's now a sub-Q form of risperidone where you could have a 1 or 2 month option right off the bat. Why would you pick one or the other?
Well, you know, it depends also on patient preference. And what would the patient actually like to receive? Something every month, every 2 months? You would think the fewer number of injections would be preferred. But that's not always the case. And I've had patients who insist on an injection every 2 weeks. Now, I'm not going to get in the way of their decision-making if that's what they really want. However, it's nice to have a variety of options to offer. The every month or every 2 month option with risperidone that you talked about is injected under the skin, subcutaneous. That's different from intramuscular. And some patients may have a preference as to what kind of injection they would prefer. They may also want a specific location for the drug to be injected in. So some patients would prefer the arm. Others would prefer the gluteal muscle. Now, why would that be?
Patients are human beings. Everyone has their own preferences. I think the most important thing is to know all the options that are out there and know how to use them effectively, meaning If it is an agent that requires oral overlap, make sure that's discussed with the patient. If they don't take the oral overlap, they may be subtherapeutic for many weeks. If it's a medication that has an initiation regimen, know how to use it. If it's a medication with a loading regimen, know how to use it. But the most important thing, I think, with LAIs more than anything is that the conversation should revolve around shared goals. What's important to the patient? What are their concerns? What are their fears? And most importantly, rinse and repeat. It's not a one-time discussion, is it?
No, it could take a while before someone goes and says, okay, I'll try it. One of the gambits I use is, you know, let's try once. If you don't like it, next time you're scheduled for an injection, we'll go back to pills. Well, when someone has experience receiving injection, has the freedom from not having to take something orally every day, they often are convinced.
It's really one of our most effective tools in psychiatry, and I think both of us would say, learn how to use them, learn how to have the conversation, and know all the options out there to get the best outcome for your patient.
Thank you for joining us at NEI's Autocomplete.